practice with child and peer, or the loosening practices. These practices help to increase the microcirculation in the whole body. The first practice is the neck movement. So bring both your feet 2 inches apart. The neck movement is contraindicated for those who have cervical spondylosis. Now bring your right palm to your right hip, left palm to the left hip. Ready? Exhale, move the head forward, allow the chin to touch the chest. Inhale, raise the head up and move it to the back as much as possible. Exhale, bend the head to the right, allowing the right ear to go as close as possible to the right shoulder. Inhale, center. Exhale, bend the head to the left side, allowing the left ear to be as close as possible to the left shoulder. Inhale, center. Now we move on to a twist. Exhale, turn the head to the right side, allowing the chin to be in line with the right shoulder. Inhale, center. Exhale, turn the head to the left side, allowing the chin to be in line with the left shoulder. Inhale, center. Exhale and relax. You may release your hands to the side. Now we move on to Skanda Chakra, shoulder rotation. Bring the tip of your fingers to the shoulders respectively. Allow the elbows to touch. Inhale, raise the elbows up to the back. And exhale, bring it down and allow the elbows to touch in front of your chest. One more round. Inhale, raise the elbows up to the back. Exhale, bring it down, allowing to touch in front of your chest. And relax. Now we move on to the trunk movement. The trunk movement is contraindicated for those who have severe back pain. Now bring your legs 1 foot apart. Stretch your arms forward, the palms facing each other. Exhale, turn the body to the left side. Place the right palm on your left shoulder. The left hand is stretched to the back. Inhale, back to the center. Exhale, turn the body to the right side. The left palm is on the right shoulder. inhale, raise both your hands up above your head, palms touching in Namaskar Mudra. Alternatively, the palms can be at your heart center. Hold for 5 breaths. This asana is a wonderful asana to improve the neuromuscular coordination. It also strengthens the muscles in the legs. On the next exhalation, bring your palms down, legs down. Now we move on to the left side. Bend your left leg, bring the left foot to your inner upper right thigh, or you may just place it above your right ankle. Once you're ready, inhale, raise your arms up above your head, palms touching in Namaskar Mudra. All the palms can even be at your heart center. Hold the posture for 5 breaths. Don't forget that beautiful smile on your face and focus at a point in front. On the next exhalation, bring your hands down and release your legs and relax. We shall now move on to the next asana. Padmasana, hands to feet pose. This asana is contraindicated for those with high blood pressure and also cardiac issues. Let's go into the asana. Inhale, raise both your hands up, stretch from your waistline. As you exhale, bring the body down very slowly, palms to the floor. If the palms do not touch the floor, you may allow it to hold any part of the leg. While in the posture, hold for 5 breaths. This asana is a wonderful asana to bring about flexibility in the spine, and it also helps to improve the digestive processes. On the next inhalation, very, very slowly bring the body up to a standing position. And exhale, you may bring the hands down to the side. From Padmasana, we shall now move on to Ardha Chakrasana, the half wheel pose. This asana is contraindicated for those with cardiac issues and also vertigo. Let's get into the practice. Place your right palm at the back of your right hip. Left palm at the back of your left hip. If the body allows it, bring both the elbows parallel to each other. Ready? Inhale, stretch the head to the back. Feel the stretch in the neck. As you exhale, bend backwards from the lumbar. This asana promotes flexibility in the spine. It also improves the lung capacity. On the next inhalation, come up to standing position. Exhale and relax. The final asana, the final standing asana for today is Trikonasana, which is the triangle pose. This asana is contraindicated for those who suffer from vertigo, and the legs apart. Move your legs right to left to just release any tension. Place the palms at the back on the floor. Relax the shoulders, relax the arms. Close the eyes. Take a moment to bring your awareness to your breath. Just observe your breath. Now you may slowly open your eyes. Now we shall begin the sitting postures. Let's start. We're going to do the Dandasana. Please sit straight up. Bring your legs together. you should start with the first supine posture or Bakrasana or the crocodile. This particular posture, if you are pregnant, please refrain from practicing. Let's begin. Spread out your legs about 2.5 to 3 feet apart. Feet point out, toes point in. Feet point out, heels point in. Stretch your hands forward. Take your left hand, fold your left hand and place the palm under your chin. Fold the right hand and place the right palm on top of left. Lift the head up, either turn your head resting onto your left side or onto your right side. Close your eyes. Stay here for 4 to 5 breaths. This asana promotes relaxation in your whole body and it also relaxes the lower back. Let's bring your awareness back to your body. We're going to move forward to the next asana called Bhujangasana, the cobra. For Bhujangasana, if you're having, or be cautious if you're having severe lower back pain, please refrain from practicing. Let's start. Take both legs together, join your legs together, bend your arms at the elbow, place the palms under your shoulders. Inhale, lift the chest up, up to your navel region if possible. Gaze forward. Hold here for 3 to 4 breaths. This asana helps to promote and strengthen the lower back. Come up from the asana, the next exhale, slowly lower the chest down and place the chin on the mat. From Bhujangasana, we're going to move to Salavasana, the locust. Bring your legs, join the legs together, feet touching. Place your hands beside your body, palms facing down, fingers point back. You may raise your leg one at a time or you may raise both legs together. Let's start. Inhale, raise both legs up or either one leg at a time with your chin on the floor. Hold here for 2 to 3 breaths. And next exhale, slowly lower your legs down. Now turn on, roll onto your back and preparing for your supine posture.
We are going to do Setu Bandhasana asanas. Relax in this pose. Your palms nearer to your hips. Bring both legs together. Down. You're going to slowly take a deep breath. Breathe in. This particular asana, those who have severe back pain, those who have hernia, please do not do these asanas. Now, slowly breathe in, breathe out. Bend your knees towards your chest and bring your heels towards your buttocks. Stay there, tie your feet on the buttocks. Your right hand holding your right ankle, left hand holding your left ankle, and relax on this pose. And bring your feet down and stay there. Your feet towards your buttocks. And in this pose, relax. If those who could not hold your ankle, just put your hands beside your hips. And now, breathe in. And while you exhale, bring your trunk up and your stomach up to the up position. Yes. And relax. Into 3 to 4 counts. Good for our constipation and those who are suffering from anxiety and depression. Now slowly exhale, bring your body down, your trunk down, your hips, and relax. Lengthen your leg back to the position and relax your hands. The next pose is Ardha Alasana. And this is a very wonderful pose where you're going to do raising up your legs, bring both legs together, palms beside your hips, and now you're going to bring your legs up to 90 degrees and do not bend your knees. For those who couldn't do this asana, you can actually do 45 degrees. Go and curl into your own space and relax here for 3 to 4 counts. Very powerful asana for constipation problems, and also relax your nervous system. And slowly relax and bring your leg down. Feel the movement of the abdomen and relax. Now, bring both hands next to your hips, palms facing down. Now we're going to do Pavan Muttasana poses. These are wind release pose. Those who have severe lower back and have been gone for an operation, please do not do, especially those who are pregnant. Now, bend both knees towards your chest, interlace your hands holding your legs, relax your neck and your shoulders. Do not go up first, just relax so that you get the right position here. While you're in this pose, you breathe in, and now when you breathe out, bring your head touching to the knees for 3 to 4 counts. And now slowly exhale, stretch your legs, lengthen your legs, relax your hands, and now slowly you're back to a relaxation position. Bring both hands, palms facing the sky. We are into Savasana, the most relaxing pose after the yoga asana. It's even called the cock pose. Now, leg apart, relax. Do not give any strain this part here because your body needs to get relaxed. Chest relax. Take a deep breath, breathe in. Breathe out, relax, close your eyes and relax. You're relaxing your mind, you're relaxing your body, and you're relaxing yourself. A beautiful relaxation after a beautiful asana of today. Now, slowly bring both legs together, palms beside your hips, palms facing down the mat. Now, bring your right hand above your head, right hand above your head, let the left hand be there, right hand above your head. Slowly move yourself to the right side by bending your knees and bring your left hand, with the support of your left hand, you're coming to a beautiful relaxation sitting position, and come up and sit in a very relaxed pose.
Abdominal muscles in to push out the breath through your nostrils.
So throughout the practice, the mouth is closed and you shall do your best to not allow any undue movement of the chest or the shoulders. So now let's get into the practice. Sit in any comfortable position. If you wish to change your sitting position, please do so now. Keep the back straight, the shoulders and arms are relaxed. Both your palms are on your knees respectively, and you shall adopt the Yana Mudra. To do the Yana Mudra, the tip of the thumb touches the tip of the index finger. The remaining three fingers are stretched out, side by side, touching. Now, close your eyes, keeping the back straight. Let's begin. Inhale deeply, exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stop. Let's do deep breathing here. Inhale deeply, exhale slowly. Moving on to the second round of Kapalabhati. Inhale deeply, exhale begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stop. Remain still. Let's do deep breathing. Inhale deeply. Exhale slowly. One last round of Kapalabhati. Ready? Inhale deeply. Exhale begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stop. You may release the mudra, but allow your eyes to remain closed. Kapalabhati helps to cleanse the frontal sinuses and also the upper respiratory tract. It also helps to provide a glow on your skin, making one look youthful. We shall now move on to the first pranayama practice, Anulom Vilom, or the alternate nostril breathing. Please allow me to explain first. In this pranayama, you will inhale to 3 counts and you will exhale to 6 counts. Your left palm shall adopt the Jnana Mudra, but the right palm will adopt the Nasagra Mudra. To do the Nasagra Mudra, you shall fold the index finger and the middle finger towards your palm. The right thumb will be used to block the right nostril. The ring finger and the little finger will be used to block the left nostril. So let's get into the practice. Use the right hand palm to block the right nostril. Inhale, left, 1, 2, 3. Block the left, open the right. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale, right, 1, 2, 3. Block the right, open the left. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is one round of Anulom Vilom. We shall do 2 more rounds. Inhale, left, 1, 2, 3. Block the left, open the right. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale, right, 1, 2, 3. Block the right, open the left. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale, left, 1, 2, 3. Block the left, open the right. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale, right, 1, 2, 3. Block the right, open the left. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You may release your hands to your knees, but let the eyes remain closed. also a wonderful pranayama to help release stress and anxiety. Now we shall move on to the next pranayama, Brahmari pranayama, the humming bee's breath. Please allow me to explain. The Brahmari pranayama is contraindicated for those who have ear and nose infection. To do this pranayama, you shall adopt the Shanmukhi Mudra. In order to do the Shanmukhi Mudra, the thumb blocks the ears. Right thumb blocks the right ear. Left thumb blocks the left ear. The second and third finger are placed above the eyes. The fourth finger above the upper lip. The fifth finger below the lower lip. This is Shanmukhi Mudra. You shall adopt this throughout the practice. So with the Shanmukhi Mudra, you will inhale through the nostril, and when you exhale, you will make a long, deep, smooth humming sound. The humming sound will not be the same for any two individuals. The duration may vary, and we will do three rounds of this. So let's get into the practice. Ready? Please adopt the Shanmukhi Mudra. Keep the back straight. Inhale through the nostrils. Exhale, hum. Release the Shanmukhi Mudra, but please allow your eyes to be closed. The Brahmari pranayama is very useful in the management of insomnia. The resonance that is created in your humming provides a soothing effect to the nerves and to the mind. Now, from here, we will move on to the most important component in yoga, that is dhyana, meditation. If you wish to change your sitting position, please do so now. Once you have assumed a very comfortable seated position, please keep your back straight, allowing it to follow the natural curvature of the spine. The shoulders are relaxed, the arms are relaxed. The palms are placed on your knees. The palms are facing upward. You may adopt the Jnana Mudra. Bring a mild focus to that space in between the eyebrows. At the same time, be conscious of your breathing. Be conscious of your inhalation. Be conscious of your exhalation. Feel the cool air flowing in through the nostrils. Feel the warm air flowing out. Thoughts may appear in your mind. Do your best to dissolve them. Slowly, we are coming out of the practice. Move your fingers, move your hands. Thank you for practicing with us today. Namaskar and happy International Yoga Day 2023.